My dear brothers and sisters, I once more welcome each and every one of us to this amazing and wonderful fellowship. And tonight we are going to take a quick reading from the book of 1 Kings, chapter 19, verse 1 to 5. The book of 1 Kings, chapter 19, verse 1 to 5. Praise the Lord. Now, Ahab told Jezebel everything Elijah had done and how he had killed all the prophets with the sword. So Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah to say, "May the gods deal with me, be it ever so severely, if by this time tomorrow I do not make your life like those one of them that you killed." Elijah was afraid and ran for his life. When he came to Beersheba in the Judah, he left his servant there, while he himself went a day's journey into the wilderness. He came to a broom bush, sat down under it, and prayed that he might die. "I have had enough, Lord," he said. "Take my life. I am no better than my ancestors." Then he lay down under the bush and fell asleep. And this is the word of the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters, God is talking to us about the prophet Elijah and the persecution he experienced in his own time, in his ministry. We all know about this man Elijah, if not for any other thing, that he prayed and the fire came down. In another episode, he also prayed and the rain started falling. We also know about Jezebel, often known for her wickedness. And these are the two prominent characters in the reading that we just read. In this night's ministration, we are going to review and reflect on the impact of Jezebel on Elijah. My dear brothers and sisters, the Bible gave us so many stories of the atrocities of Jezebel, how she was manipulating her husband, manipulating people, and now it is time for her to manipulate Elijah. I want you to take notes that in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 1, the Bible says that now Ahab told Jezebel everything Elijah had done. And now he had killed all the prophets with the sword. We know that Elijah, God used him to do great things in Israel. And there was a time that Israel deviated from the true God and started worshiping Baals. And these Baals were the system of Jezebel. Jezebel brought in and emphasized the worship of Baals. Now, but God used Elijah to bring back the people. And in that process, he prayed on fire to come down. And then he killed, some prophets, about 450 prophets. Now, this news came to Jezebel, through who? Ahab. Ahab was the husband of Jezebel. The husband of Jezebel. That's Ahab. Now, the Bible says that Ahab told Jezebel everything that Elijah did. How Elijah brought back the people back to God. How Elijah killed the prophets of Baal. He told Jezebel all these things. Why? Because Jezebel was manipulating Ahab. You see that? There was a time that this Ahab had to go and take a land plot that does not belong to him, his neighbor's land plot. It was this same Jezebel that manipulated him to do that. So the Bible has so many stories about the atrocities of Jezebel. The testimony of the scripture in 1 Kings 19 verse 2 reveals the nature of Jezebel. Look at what the Bible says in 1 Kings 19 verse 2. So Jezebel sent a messenger to Elijah to say, "May the gods deal with me if by this time tomorrow you are not dead." That was the message that Jezebel sent to Elijah after hearing what Elijah did. In other words, she swore that Elijah must die, that she must kill Elijah. My brothers and sisters, I want to ask you, how do you describe this Jezebel? Wicked woman, right? If you are still at the level of looking at Jezebel as a wicked person, then you are even underrating her, really. Jezebel is a killer. I use the word is, not was, because if we say was, then you are referring to the past as if she had changed. But that same spirit of Jezebel is still alive today, manipulating people, killing people. A killer spirit, a killer of destiny, a killer of vision, a killer of anointing. Look at Elijah. I mean, this was a high-ranking prophet. All right? The most prominent prophet. Someone who would pray and fire will come down. Full of anointing. But Jezebel had a project to kill Elijah in less than 24 hours. That same spirit is still in the world today, looking for people with anointing, people with calling of God upon their lives to kill them, to quench the fire. So we are here tonight to pray against killer spirits. It may be coming to you in the form of sickness. Cancer is from the office of Jezebel. It was a killer spirit. AIDS, and so on and so forth. These are killer spirits. These are the children and the grandchildren and the great-grandchildren of Jezebel. Anywhere they come, they want to kill. But the message this night is that the same God that delivered our brother Elijah from the hands of the killer will also deliver you. I don't know the one you are struggling with. I don't know the killer spirit that is against you. I don't know how many years they have been scheming and strategizing on how to strike the attack. But we know that the God of Elijah will deliver people today. God who delivered Elijah wants to deliver you. Let me tell you, in spite of the fact that Jezebel made all these schemes against our brother, the prophet Elijah, God in heaven vindicated Elijah. But when these things were happening, Elijah thought that God had abandoned him. Elijah was full of fear. Wow. Jesus. Remember that it was not Jezebel that told Elijah directly that she would kill him by morning of the next day. The Bible says that Jezebel messenger, her messenger, to convey this message to the prophet Elijah, that Elijah will die by this day. The messenger. Jezebel spirits have messengers. The messenger is a demon, is an evil spirit. Sometimes you're in a dream and you'll be given a date to die. A lot of people tell me such dreams. That's the messenger of Jezebel. But the prayer of today is against Jezebel and all her weapon of warfare, including her associates, her messengers. A messenger is meant to monitor, to deliver a message. There's a spirit called a spying spirit. Spying spirit. They spy. They monitor. And then pass information to the spirits that will now carry out the operation. That was the mission of the messenger. Messenger just came to tell our brother Elijah what would happen. And then get information about Elijah and where Elijah was. Back to the wicked Jezebel. My brothers and sisters, if you take time to read the book of 1 Kings, chapter 19, you will see in totality that this same Jezebel sent so many other prophets, evil prophets, Baals, her messengers, to go and tell Elijah that he must die. Not one, he said, not two, not three. So many of them. Spying spirits. Some of them were sent to get an information where Elijah was. There are spirits that their duty is to get information of the opportunities you have so that they know how to scatter opportunities. They want to get information about your business prospects so that they now pass information back to the spirit that will come to attack and scatter the opportunity. You keep wondering, why is it that for most people, when they receive money, they are paid at the end of the month, that's when troubles come. And that trouble cannot come to an end until the money finishes. Because there is a monitoring spirit, a messenger of Jezebel that's after your finances to make sure you don't have anything left in the account. They will get the information and they will pass the message. So we are coming against messengers of Jezebel, officials of Jezebel, anywhere they are, whether they are using their telescopic spirits or binoculars or whatever thing they are using in a satanic kingdom to monitor the children of God, let the power of God arise and destroy them in the name of Jesus. All their broadcasting stations through which they are using to broadcast our problems, to transfer information, we cancel such networks in the name of Jesus. Jesus. Have you ever asked yourself why most people, they may be living in a particular city, and they say, oh my God, ever since I moved to this city, it has been trouble, trouble, trouble. Ever since I moved to this subdivision or into this house, it has been problems. In fact, let me move out of this place and go to another place. You move to another city, maybe another state, the same problem is there. I have heard people say, oh, I wish I could find myself in overseas so that I live out of these problems. And we go to overseas and the same thing is still happening. You don't know that is a system monitoring you. There are messengers of Jezebel monitoring you. You don't know that they are using telescope to monitor you. There are broadcasting stations that are used to transfer information to you. I said it in prayer line some time ago when I was living in a city called Port Harcourt in Nigeria. I was passing through a lot of attacks at that time. And then one day I had a revelation that opened my eyes. And I saw some spirits that came to the land where I was born. I mean, I come from the state called Enugu State. And then from Port Harcourt to Enugu State is like 300 miles. And I saw these spirits, they came to my hometown. And they visited the principalities and powers in charge of my hometown. And look at the conversation. And they told the principals and powers in my hometown and said that there is a young man born in this town, living in Port Harcourt. Our master, Queen of the Coast, has tried everything possible to track him down, to destroy him, but never succeeded. And they have been wondering, why was it impossible to get him? And so our master now sent us to come to you to find out and to give us information how to deal with Blood Wakwe and get him and kill him. I was just listening to the spirit. Conversation was going on. You see, there is a network. They wanted to attack Blood Wakwe and they couldn't. They were wondering what to do. So the spirit now sent his messengers to go and get a file. In fact, they requested for file when they came to my community. They told the spirit, please, our master said, give us information about him from his file. I was surprised that day. That opened my eyes. And it never occurred to me that we have files. You know, when you're walking, you have your file with you. And that's where everything about you is documented. And so they came to get information about Barwake from his file. So as to know how to deal with him. In your file, they will know your weakness. They will put it down. This is his weakness. This is his strength. This is how to attack him. You attack him at the point of weakness, and so on and so forth. And that was what they needed to know. You see, these spirits are not omnipotent. That's why they're seeking to hunt for information. They are hunting for information. Because they're not omniscient. They don't know everything. God is omniscient and omnipotent and omnipresent. So these spirits have to travel because they are not omnipresent. God doesn't need to travel. You see that? God doesn't need to inquire or to find somebody's file. No. Everything is just before him. And so when this thing came, they wanted to get the file so as to know how to deal with someone. And so the spirit now told them, say, look, right from the day he was born, we came to take him, we came to attack him, but we could not. That even because of him, we could not even attack his siblings or members of his family. So my brothers and sisters, had it been that they were able to get the information, they would have been able to start attacking brother. So I'm sharing this with you for you to understand why when you move from one place to the other because of the situation you're passing through, or you move from one marriage to another marriage, or from one business to another business, you know, and the same thing is happening. And you keep wondering, why is my own story different? It is because the messenger of Jezebel is monitoring you. Do you understand what I'm talking about now? Jesus. So, my dear people of God, the fact is that the file of every child of God is in the hand of God. And so when they want to get information about you, they cannot get it because we are hidden with Christ in God, as Colossians chapter 3, verse 3 tells us. So when they want to get any information, they can get it. Because your fire is hidden in Christ. Your life is hidden in Christ. Everything about you is in Christ. Your glory is in Christ. Your testimony is in Christ. Your promotion is in Christ. That's why you cannot touch it. Your marriage is in Christ. That's why they cannot touch it. When you put your life in Christ, then you become untouchable. The enemy cannot do anything. They cannot succeed. You see, when you are not in Christ, you are vulnerable or porous to anything the devil wants to do. You see that? When the enemy has succeeded in capturing somebody, the person cannot wear the glory of God again. You see, I was praying for somebody some few days ago, and in the course of the prayer, it manifestation started, and then I entered into deliverance, and in the course of the deliverance, the angels of God came down and down removed the garment of iniquities, garment of shame, garment of darkness that lady was wearing. And at the moment those things were taken away, now behold, Jesus came in. Jesus came in, Mother Mary appeared, the angels appeared, and they gave her a white cloth, stainless. You see the point? So many of us are wearing, some garments that enemies have forced us to wear because they have sent the Jezebel spirit to come and give you a clothing that you don't deserve. But I'm praying this day that as many as are under such monitoring spirits, such messengers of Jezebel, such spirits that are monitoring you, converting information to the demonic kingdom, so that they will enrich their database with your information. May the power of the God of this ministry, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, let him come and vindicate you. Let the God of Elijah come and fight a battle for you. Every power from the court headquarters that are planning to pull you down, to destroy your finances, to make it impossible for you to come out of that mess, to come out of that ugly story, may God vindicate you. May God deliver you from that situation in the name of Jesus. Whatever is the ugly situation, I am calling on God to come and vindicate you in the name of Jesus. Every power that is making it difficult for you to pay your rent so that you remain at the mercy of the mortgage, may God Almighty come down from his heavenly throne and arise and fight a battle for you in the name of Jesus. Every spirit, that has been injected into your body, that killer spirit, that Jezebel spirit, I command that spirit in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. I command such spirit to wither in the name of Jesus. As the fig tree withered under the command of Jesus, so I command cancer right now in the name of the Eucharistic Jesus. Wither in the name of Jesus. Jesus. People that have been monitored by Jezebel spirits, by messengers of the Jezebel spirits, Holy Father, deliver them now. All the networks they are using to monitor your children, to monitor their blessings, to monitor their positions, to monitor their promotions, to monitor when they will be pregnant, so as to cause miscarriage. Holy Father, in the course of the prayer, send your own messengers. Send your angels, Lord. Those ministering angels, those ministering spirits that you told us about in Hebrews chapter 1 verse 7. Father, send them now. In your mercy, send them now. In the time of Daniel, you sent them. You sent them in Daniel chapter 10, verse 4 and following. And then the prince of Persia that arrested the blessings and the angel of testimony for brother Daniel. You sent the angel Michael to dethrone that prince of Persia. Every prince of Persia holding the testimony of your children in the air, holding the glory of your people in the air. Oh, Jesus, let the hand of such spirits break into pieces. Let angel Michael appear in the name of Jesus and fight the battle of the children of God. Let him do what he did in the time of Daniel, so that people's blessings shall reach to them. Any person whose blessing is hanging in the atmosphere, let the power of God bring down your apples, bring down your testimonies. Let your gold sediment in the name of Jesus. Let your reign of glory begin to precipitate now in the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. prophesy. I cancel them now. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Every power messing up with my file, manipulating my file, my immigration file, my job file, my health file. Jesus, let those spirits now that want to tamper with my file, let them be destroyed now. Any spirit that wants to manipulate my DNA file, let the power of Jesus, through the prayer, destroy such a mandate and conspiracy. In the name of Jesus. Aha! Jesus! Jesus! Come and deliver your people. Come and deliver your people. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Jesus! Remember what we're talking about. That Jezebel sent her messenger to go and tell Elijah that by next morning, Elijah must be dead. I don't know the spirit that has been sent to bring a bad news to you, to terrify you, but we're here to say, Holy Ghost, fire! We cancel such mandates, such decisions in the occulting headquarters, in the witchcraft covens. Anywhere they have planned it, we nullify by the power of the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, people that the enemies have given this year for them to die, or enemies have given a particular date for them to die, hey, just like they gave a date for Elijah to die, without respect for his anointing. But Jesus, at this hour, I cancel that decision. I cancel it in the name of Jesus. I cancel it in the name of Jesus. Jesus, every decision made and stamped in the occultic quarters, declaring the death of a child of God, I cancel it now. I cancel it now. The Bible says, I shall live, I shall not die. I shall be alive in the land of the living to testify the goodness of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Anywhere they have planned it, we cancel now. We cancel now. We cancel now. We cancel now. In the name of Jesus. Every problem, sickness in the blood, sickness in the plasma, sickness in the bones that are waiting to take you to the grave. You are wasting your time. In the name of Jesus, come out and go to the Ibis right now. Jesus, let the blood of Jesus begin to touch somebody now. Begin to touch your family. Begin to touch your family. Begin to touch your destiny. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. May the Lord bestow you with favor. May the Lord deliver you now. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 18 says, the Lord will rescue me from every evil attack and will bring me safely to his heavenly kingdom, and to him be glory and honor and majesty. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Every project carried out by the kingdom of darkness against the children of God, I cancel it now. We cancel it now. We cancel it now. In the name of Jesus. Whatever the situation, every project, demonic projects, Jezebel projects that are working against me, against my life, against my family, against my glory, against my testimony, let them burn by fire. Let them be destroyed now. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Oh, my dear people of God, this was the situation of a man called Prophet Elijah. A man full of anointing, but Jezebel could not respect his anointing. Jezebel is a wicked and a stubborn spirit. Can you imagine something that will make Elijah, the man who called down fire from heaven, to run and run into the wilderness and start living among the wild That thing must be serious. That thing must be powerful. Jesus. The Bible says that Elijah was terrified. He ran for his life. You know, when he heard that he was to die next day, he had to run. Elijah, the Bible says in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 4, Elijah had a day's journey into the wilderness. Can you imagine? Situations forced him to live where human beings were living and went into the wilds, to the wilderness. That was the same thing that happened to our brother David when there was problem in his house and one of his sons called Absalom wanted to kill him. Do you know that David ran out of his palace without slippers, without shoes, without sandals? He ran. At least let him be alive. And then another day he could wear his sandals. And then he ran out and was living where he was not supposed to live. In fact, on the way, where he was running from his son, a beggar saw him and set a true stone on him. A whole David, a king. Sometimes situation can make people want to talk to you, to talk to you. That was what happened to David. At a point, Saul was after David. And David was now living in the cave. This was the king. But the situation forced him to the cave. Many of us are living in the cave right now, spiritually, because of us. Because situation has forced us out of our glory. So this was what happened to Elijah. And so he went to the wilderness and he started to pray. Look at his prayer. God, I have had enough. I have had enough. Take my life. How many of you have made that kind of prayer? My hand is up. Oh. I have made that kind of prayer. Oh. There are things that will happen to you. You will tell God, take my life. I'm done. When you don't have joy again, everywhere around you is problems. You appear to be at the center of the ocean. Anything you do, problem, troubles. No good news. No encouragement. You do good, trouble. You don't do good. Oh, that's what the worst. So you can see the prayer of a troubled heart in the prayer of Elijah. Somebody who went to the wilderness. And the prayer was, God, kill me. I want to die. I'm not better than my ancestors. That's the prayer of a troubled heart. A prayer of a heart in despair. He was frustrated. Fear took over him. The Bible recorded several wonders that God used Elijah to do. In all, he was bold. All right? We see that boldness in Elijah when in 1 Kings 18, verse 8, Elijah said to Obadiah, go. Tell your master Ahab that Elijah is here. All this time they were looking for Elijah. They were looking for him. Weeks upon weeks, months upon months, they were looking for him to kill him. And now, what would make Elijah to come to the door of Ahab and tell Obadiah, tell your master Ahab that Elijah is here? That's boldness. He was bold to confront Ahab, but not the wife. Elijah was able to confront Ahab, but not the wife of Ahab. Think about that. Jesus. Some women could be powerful, right? He rather chose to run to the wilderness to facing Jezebel. And now he was praying for his death. When Elijah met Ahab in 1 Kings 18 verse 17, you know what Ahab said? Hey, is that you? You troubler of Israel. Take note. You troubler of Israel. Hey, yeah. child of God. Did you take notice of that word, troubler? Meaning that Elijah single-handedly was troubling Israel, troubling the powers of the land, troubling the government single-handedly, troubling Ahab, troubling everywhere that evil was in Israel. He killed 450 Baal, prophets of Baal, single-handedly. So it makes sense for Ahab to call him troubler. He said, let me tell you, if the enemy does not see you as a troubler, then you are cold. Then your prayer is not going anywhere. Any child of God that uses the power of God to do great exploits is a troubler. So if there are troubler to come out, don't ever swear that you have not troubled anybody. As far as you are a child of God, you are a troubler to the enemy. So don't deny that you are a troubler. You are a troubler. Trouble in the spirit. Trouble them with your prayer. Trouble them with your fasting. Trouble them with your trust in God. Yes. Because Elijah was bold, he confronted Ahab. And face to face, they were talking. In another event, this same Elijah, in 2 Kings 1 verse 10, said, if I be a man of God, may fire come down from heaven and consume you and your filthy men. The moment he said that, fire came down from heaven and consumed the captain and his men. Elijah, the same Elijah, called down fire from heaven to restore, in an attempt to restore the true worship of God in Israel. He single-handedly killed 450 prophets of Baal. Elijah commanded heavens to cease rain, and the heavens obeyed. He also commanded heaven to cease rain, and the heavens obeyed. So why then should Elijah run away from Jezebel this time? This is a question. Think about it. A man who could do all these things, couldn't he have called the same fire to come and destroy Jezebel? But the moment Jezebel opened his mouth, he ran into the wilderness. Jesus. What could have caused Elijah, the wonder worker, with the fire ministry, a firebrand Christian, anointed man of God, what would make him to run to the wilderness just because Jezebel opened her mouth is something of a concern to all of us. That many of us fear certain entities. And when we fear them, then they will start attacking us. And that's what happened. Elijah was afraid of Jezebel. And Jezebel took advantage and started dealing with him. Wait a minute. Where is Jezebel now? In the grave, yeah, right? Oh, yeah. Jezebel is not in the grave, sister. Brother, are you supposed to hear that from me? Jezebel is not in the grave. No, Jezebel is not in the grave. I repeat it again. Because Jezebel is not a person. Jezebel is a spirit. It's a spirit that releases demonic controlling and manipulating witchcraft influences against people's minds, against people's lives, against the anointed. Brothers and sisters, it is time for us to understand that Jezebel is no more a wife in the house of Ahab. It's simply a spirit haunting the children of God to kill the purpose of God in their lives. Some of us have been chased to an uncomfortable state in life, like Elijah, by Jezebel. You are probably warring. Oh my goodness. I say you are probably doing what? Warring against unseen spirits, unseen forces that are trying to destroy your life, your family, your ministry, or even your future. You don't know that you are under the attack of Jezebel and her cohorts. Right now, we can stop the spirit of Jezebel by the power that comes from above. I am talking about the power of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. We shall not let another day go by without destroying Jezebel. Jezebel's life span must terminate tonight. Yes, Lord. A powerful arsenal at disposition for Jezebel is the fear. You see, what made Elijah to run into the wilderness when Jezebel talked was fear. The arrow of fear hit this anointed man, Elijah. And that's what happened in our lives. When we become afraid of things, they will start influencing us. Even Job says, what I feared finally came to me. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7, that God had not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. The psalmist says in Psalm 34, verse 4, I sought the Lord and he heard me, and I delivered me from all my fears. Jezebel, as a manipulator, manipulated fear into the life of Elijah. When this was done, Elijah became afraid and ran for his life. I am praying for you now. Whatever spirit of fear that has been injected into your life, fear of height, fear of water, fear of staying in a place without light, fear of being alone, fear of the future, fear of the past, whatever it is, I call upon the power of the blood of Jesus to destroy such spirit of fear in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Every arrow of fear injected into the life of the children of God, let such fear be destroyed now. Let the blood of Jesus destroy every signature of fear in my life in the name of Jesus. That spirit that tells me that disease, that sickness will kill me, I say it will not come to pass in the name of Jesus. This sickness, I will see the end of it. That sickness, that cancer, will not see my end. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. You can say that prayer right now. Yes, my Lord. Whatever they are passing through, you can say that you will see the end of that thing. That thing cannot see your end. You can prophesy it now. Jesus. My dear brothers and sisters, I tell you that when fear steps in, faith steps out. I repeat. When fear steps in, faith steps out. In other words, fear is opposed to faith. So we are praying and asking God to paralyze and destroy every power that wants to quench our faith. Jesus. Every messenger of Jezebel dedicated to deceive me, I cancel them now and let them burn into pieces in the name of Jesus. Jesus. The Bible says in Psalm 27, verse 1 to 3, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is my light and the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though a host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. Do you have confidence in your God? Look at the prayer of David in this Psalm 27, verse 1 to 3. That the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? In other words, David was saying, whom shall I fear? Even Jezebel, I cannot fear you. Somebody can say that this night. Say, the Lord is the strength of my life. I will not fear Jezebel. I will not fear the wicked spirits. I will not fear the foes. They may want to eat my flesh. Though witches and wizards may want to drink my blood or eat my flesh, the Lord said they will stumble and they will fall. Because the Lord is with you. Though the enemies may encamp against me or against us, the Lord says, my heart will not fear. Though they may war against me, I will not fear Jezebel's spirit. I will not fear her workers in her vineyard, in her garden. I will not fear her messengers. That was the prayer of David. A man that knows the power of his God. Do you know the power of your God? Then you can trust him. Psalm 34 verse 4 says, and that's David talking, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. From all my fears. So what is a fear? Even if that fear is manufactured from Jezebel's factory, I tell you that God will deliver you from that fear. David says, the Lord delivered me from all my fear, not some, all my fears. Psalm 34 verse 4. Yes, Lord. May the Lord deliver us from all our fears in the name of Jesus. Now, when Goliath confronted David, challenged him, the size of Goliath was enough to intimidate David, to make David to run. Remember that even Saul, a war general, couldn't confront Goliath. Israel, as a nation, had gone to war in different nations, came back victoriously, but none could confront Goliath. How come this small boy, a shepherd, was the one that confronted Goliath and killed him? Because David knew that his God would deliver him from all the troubles. Remember Psalm 34, verse 19. That the Lord will always deliver the righteous. Yes, Lord. Whatever the trouble, the Lord will deliver us from all them all. In the name of Jesus. Though many are the affliction of the righteous, the Lord will deliver them from them all. He knew that. And that was why in Psalm 18, verse 50, David says, the Lord delivered his king from the great warrior, from the great attacker, from the great enemy. Indeed, Goliath was a great enemy. Jesus, that God is here with you. That God of Israel is here. He's here to touch his people. He's here to fight for his people, to vindicate them from every negative arrow, from the arrow of death, from arrow of sickness, because the Lord is the God who vindicates his children, who fights their battle. And let the word of God that is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword pierce through every negative thought or speech that have been made against us, that we are suffering or carrying like a badge. May all of them be paralyzed and be destroyed now. Let such spirits be turned into truth, such negative thoughts, even the ones we spoke against ourselves ignorantly, that are affecting our lives today. Let the power of the God of David deliver us in the name of Jesus. Let the God of Elijah, who delivered Elijah from the hands of Jezebel and her spirits, her workers, her messengers, may that same God deliver us from such spirits in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. The Bible says that he who is in me is greater than he who is in the world. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, I conquer darkness. I conquer Jezebel. I conquer her cohorts. I conquer her messengers. I conquer Ahab. In the name of Jesus, every Jezebel spirit in my house, every Ahab spirit in my business, I command you now, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, be consumed by fire. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord, I will not fear again. In fact, I received the grace of divine boldness. The angel of the Lord encamp around me. In the name of Jesus. And so I shall not fear the enemy. The angel of the Lord are with me. I have no basis to fear any man or any evil, or any evil spirit. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, Holy Father, you remain my God and my Father. And so I know that since you are with me, that I am safe. For your word says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 18, that you will rescue me from every evil attack. And so, Father, not only shall you rescue me from evil attacks, but the Bible also says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 18b, that the Lord will bring me safely to his heavenly kingdom. And to him be all glory. My Lord and my Father, the hour has come. Come and touch your children. Your word says in Haggai, chapter 2, verse 4, I am with you, says the Lord. Father, come and be with me and my people. In this time of problems, In this hard time of troubles, come and vindicate your people. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. And the Bible asks a question. In Isaiah chapter 49, verse 24. Who can demand that a tyrant may let his captive go? Oh, Jesus. Who can demand that a sheep in the mouth of the lion shall escape? Oh, Jesus. The Bible answers that question in Isaiah chapter 49, verse 25. But this is what the Lord says. Yes. Captives will be taken from the warrior, and the plunder retrieved from the fierce. I will contend with those who contend with you, and your children I will save. My dear brothers and sisters, that provision is for you. Therefore, every power, every warrior, every power, every tyrant, oh, every terrorist, spiritual terrorist, conspiring and regrouping against the children of God. Oh, Jesus, may the Lord Almighty contend with them. In the name of Jesus. I don't know how many times you have been a victim in the hands of Jezebel and her agents. But now, the Bible says in Isaiah 7:7, this invasion will not happen again. It will not happen again. I say it will not happen again. Hey, Jesus, Isaiah chapter 7 verse 7 says, this invasion of Jezebel, this invasion of Jezebel in my life, in my family, in my business, oh, no more. The Bible says it shall not happen again. It shall not happen again. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, we declare the burial of Jezebel and her household. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. And the Bible says, Exodus 3 verse 7, the Lord said, I have indeed seen the misery of my people in Egypt. I don't know what the misery is like for you, but the Lord Almighty says, he has indeed seen your misery. He has seen your suffering, and he will make way for you. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, may the Lord deliver you. Every despair, every burden on the shoulder of my people, laid on their shoulders by Jezebel and her missionaries. May the power of God Almighty destroy them now. Destroy that despair. Destroy that burden. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, Holy Father, arise and fight my battle. Father, we need you. Papa, we need you. Come and touch your people. Come and touch your people. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, let the blood of Jesus change my ugly story. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, Isaiah 3 verse 10, tell the righteous that it is well with them. My dear brothers and sisters, I am here to give a special announcement that it is well with you. Because the Bible says so. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, every setup against me, we cancel now. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, the Bible says, Psalm 71, verse 21, thou shalt increase my greatness and comfort me on every side. Hey, Jesus, every power of Jezebel planning to subdue me, to demote me, oh, to make me to decrease. The Bible says in Psalm 21 that I shall increase, and the Lord shall make me to increase, and he will increase my greatness, and he will comfort me on every side. My dear people of God, it is time to comfort you. It is time to comfort you. Jesus, maybe your name is Comfort. Oh, Jesus, that is my name now. My name is Comfort, because the Lord wants to comfort me. In the name of Jesus, I take it as a name. I wear it as a cloth. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Pray now, pray now, pray now. Yes, my Lord. Whatever thing that Jezebel has taken out of your life, may the Lord restore. Restore 1,000 times. According to Genesis chapter 24, verse 60, where the Bible says, may you increase thousands upon thousands. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, let your power flow. Let your power flow. Papa, touch me now. Papa, touch me now. The throne. The reign of Jezebel in my heart, in my family. In the name of Jesus. Every wicked husband, every wicked wife, may the Lord touch you now. May the Lord give you a new heart. In the name of Jesus. The Bible says, Ezekiel 33, verse 26. Aha! I will give you a new heart, and I will put a new spirit in you. I will remove from your heart the heart of stone, and I will give you the heart of flesh. My dear people of God, let me tell you something. Oh, the heart of stone, it means the heart of Jezebel. And the Bible says, he will remove the heart of Jezebel and put the heart of love, a new spirit, new heart. We're asking God Almighty this night, let him send his heavenly surgeons to go and do surgery of a heart transplant. Yes, a heart transplant from taking away the heart of stone and putting a new heart, the heart of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus, removing the heart of wickedness, the heart of Jezebel, and putting the heart of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, Jesus, let the blood of Jesus begin to touch us now. Begin to touch us now. In the name of Jesus, yes, my Lord. Jesus, Father, have your way. Father, deliver me in my situation now. Jesus, every pain in my life caused by Jezebel, we command it to disappear because it is time for me to smile. In the name of Jesus, every confusion in my life caused by Jezebel, I cancel you because it is time for me to be understood. In the name of Jesus, and I also to understand every betrayal in my life caused by Jezebel, I bind you because it's time for me to trust. In the name of Jesus, every chaos in my life, in my marriage, in my destiny caused by Jezebel, I cancel. Yes, my Lord, because it's time for me to have peace. In the name of Jesus, every scarcity in my life caused by Jezebel, I cancel you now. I set you on fire because it's the time for me to have enough. In the name of Jesus. Jesus, every agony in my life caused by Jezebel, I bind you. Yes, my Lord. Jesus, I bind every spirit of agony because it's time for me to have joy. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. It's time for me to move forward. No more stagnation. In the name of Jesus, every wall built against me by Jezebel, so that I will not move forward in life, I command you now, in the name of Jesus, burn by fire. Burn by fire. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Let my life be too hot for Jezebel to handle. Let my life, my family be too hot for Jezebel to play with. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Papa, have your way. Papa, have your way. Yes, my Lord Jesus. Come and do something in my life. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. Have your way, Lord. We depend on you. You are our helper. The Bible says, Psalm 124, verse 8, our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. Father, we are depending on you because you are our helper. Come and help me, Lord. Come and help your people. In the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Jesus. I know that, Father, that through this prayer, you are changing my ugly story. In the name of Jesus. Deliver me now. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. Engrave me in the palms of your hands. Jesus. Yes, my Lord. Yes, my Lord. For the Bible says, Isaiah chapter 49, verse 16, I have engraved you in the palms of my hand, says the Lord. Father, hide me in the palms of your hand, so that when Jezebel comes, she will not see me. In the name of Jesus, Make me invisible to the eyes of Jezebel. In the name of Jesus, every rod of Jezebel, rod of Jezebel, rod of wickedness in my life, I cancel, I cancel, I cancel, I cancel. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. The Bible says, Psalm 125 verse 3, the scepter of wicked will not remain over the land allotted for the righteous. Yes, my Lord. My dear people of God, there is a scepter, a rod, a staff called the scepter of wickedness. That is an instrument in the hand of Jezebel. But the Bible tells us that the scepter of wickedness shall be found in the family of the righteous. Yet you see Jezebel using her rod, her scepter, to fight the people of God, including the whole Elijah. I don't know the one you are struggling with. Maybe you are struggling with the scepter of wickedness manufactured in the factory of Jezebel. But the Bible says in Isaiah 14 verse 5 that the Lord has broken the rod of wickedness, the scepter of the rulers. And so we command every rod in the hand of Jezebel to be broken now. To be broken now. Let them be broken now. Let them be broken now. In the name of Jesus. Jesus. May the Lord comfort you. May the Lord strengthen you. In the name of Jesus. People that have been weeping because Jezebel have been flogging them with her scepter of wickedness. Yeah. And the people of God have been weeping for years. But now I'm praying that God will bring compassion for you. May God wipe your tears. Jeremiah chapter 31 verse 9 says, with weeping they shall come, but with compassion I will guide them, for I am their father, the father of Israel. Thank you, Jesus, for being our father, for being our God, for putting laughter into my mouth, into the mouth of your people. In Job chapter 8 verse 21, the Bible says, he will yet fill your mouth with laughter and your lips with shouts of joy. And Job chapter 5 verse 22 says, you will laugh at destruction and the famine, and you need not fear the wild animals. My dear brothers and sisters, this is no more the time to fear. Don't fear that wild animal. Don't fear that Jezebel. May God bless you. Be still and know that I'm God, says the Lord. Psalm 46 verse 10. May God protect us. May God strengthen us. And may God be with us. May God be our defense in the name of Jesus. May he threaten and destroy every work of darkness against the children of God. In the name of Jesus, I soak you with the blood of Jesus. I cover you with the blood of Jesus. May the Lord be with you. May the Lord strengthen you. May the Lord bless you from Zion. May the Lord who has brought you far preserve your testimony to his glory. This and many more we pray through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen and amen. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. If you need this message in your CD, you call this number to get your CD, 248-688-6195. 248-688-6195. We continue to remind members of this ministry that our mega convention of 2016 is going to be at Dallas, and that's going to be on 24th, 25th, and 26th of June, 2016. Please plan to be there. You can't afford to miss it. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Tomorrow, fasting continues, and tomorrow we are going to read the book of Jeremiah, chapter 32. Jeremiah chapter 32. Jeremiah chapter 32. That's our reading. Jeremiah chapter 32, verse 17b says, nothing is too hard for you. Nothing is too hard for you. Do you believe that? I do. I do believe that nothing is too hard for God. Now, whatever thing that you are struggling, I mean the difficult ones, difficult problem, present them to God tomorrow and tell God, nothing is too hard for you. Even this sickness, even this cancer, even this business, even this news in my place of work, even this ugly situation, even this immigration problem, I know it is nothing for you. So tell God about that. Remember 2 Kings chapter 3, verse 18. This is an easy thing in the eyes of God. Matthew chapter 19, verse 26 says, with man, this is impossible. But with God, all things are possible. Luke 1, verse 37 says, for with God, nothing shall be impossible. And so I ask you this question. Genesis chapter 18, verse 14. Is anything too hard for God? I leave it for you to answer. But I can predict your answer. And God bless you as you trust in the Lord. In Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Tomorrow's fasting 6 to 1, as usual. And tomorrow we continue to call on the Lord to solve our difficult problems and be with us in Jesus' name. I continue to ask for your prayers to pray for Brother Wakwe and his family and his job. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. We cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. I want to use the opportunity to ask for us, all of us, to pray for every member of this ministry that have terminal diseases, terminal problems, terminal disease, terminal problems, problems that appear to have gone out of control of human beings. It's, for example, cancer. We are lifting such people to the Lord in prayer now. We're asking the Almighty God to destroy such spirits in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let every scepter of wickedness, scepter of cancer, sorrow, Kereba, we command you now in the name of Jesus. Come out! Come out! Come out from the heart of the people. Come out from the bones of my children. Come out from the flesh of my people. Come out from the blood of my people. Come out from the life of my people. In the name of Jesus, receive the blood of Jesus. Anyone that is having terminal problem, terminal disease, let the power of blood of Jesus remove that scepter of wickedness. Let the Lord remove it now. Let the power of God uproot and destroy every scepter of wickedness in the life of the children of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. People that are finding it difficult to pay their rent, may God Almighty remove that scepter of wickedness and give you favor to pay that rent and let you open the door to the glory of his name. In Jesus' super mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen.